Hello students, welcome to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School channel. Myself Priya teacher and today I am going to teach you science subject for class 7. So children, in our previous lesson we completed our lesson number 12, reproduction in plants. So today we will start our new lesson. But before that, tell me that all you are now at home only, okay? So anywhere you are not going. So only at home you are living there, and also your parents are for 2-3 months they also not went anywhere. It means for working also they not went. So you are getting bored, but also you can play at your home, or some indoor games also you can play at your home, isn't it? Correct. But only for garden you can't go, or for picnic, for trip you can't go anywhere. But children, tell me, so in your previous class you learned about all these concepts. What concepts? So is any animal can move from one place to another. So when that animal can move from one place to another, what that is called exactly in science language? Yes, correct, very good. So whenever that animal or living organism is going to move from one place to another, that is called as a movement, okay? And some animals can move from their places and some animals cannot move from their places. But plants cannot move from their place. There are some living organisms which can move, but some non-living things are also can move from their place and cannot move from their place. Okay, so are you getting confused? So don't get confused, because I am telling about the motion. Okay, so whenever there are non-living things, with some technology we can make these things to move from one place to another, or we can make movement in them, in these type of non-living things. Sorry. So whenever there is a motion, so you learned about this motion and also types of motion. So can you tell me which are the types of motion? Okay, correct. So there are different types of motion which are known as a periodic motion, straight motion and pendulum, also pendulum motion. So these you learn, these concepts you learn in your previous class. So today we will start which is going to give you a more information about this motion and types of motion and how we can measure different types of motion also. Okay, so let us start our lesson number 13, motion and time. So see children, in 6th class you learned about these concepts, which are these motions, then straight line motion, circular or periodic motion, and also the type of which is the type of pendulum motion. Okay, so then here it is given a table number 13.1. so this is nothing but, so only recall whatever you learnt in your previous class. So this table you have to complete. So this table number 13.1, these are in this some examples of different types of motion are given here. So type of motion along a straight line or circular or periodic. So here some examples are given in a first column, and then in second column you have to write what is the type of, or what particular type of motion these examples are having. So that you have to write here. So first I am going to read. So I am not going to tell you answers, because you learned these concepts in your previous class. So you only have to complete this table. Only I am going to read examples. First it is the soldiers in a march pass. So all you also do march pass whenever there is a 26th of January and 15th of August, that time you do this march pass. So you know what is the type of motion of these soldiers. Okay, so you have to write this type of motion in front of this first example. Then second one, it is a bullock cart moving on a straight road. Then third one, it is hands of an athlete in a race. Then fourth, pedal of a bicycle in a motion of the earth around the sun, motion of a swing, then motion of a pendulum. So you have to write which type is there of this each example. If you will not get answer, then I will tell you in our next session. Okay, children? So let us move. So first point of our lesson, which is 13.1, slow or fast. So we know that some vehicles move faster than others. Even the same vehicle may move faster or slower at different times. So make a list of 10 objects moving along a straight path. So group the motion of these objects as slow and fast. So what is given here? So we know that there are some vehicles which are having faster speed, or they can move faster, and some vehicles can move slower. So you have to make a list of 10 objects. So what you have to do, you have to make a list of 10 objects which moving along a straight path. So you have to make a list in which you have to mention whatever vehicles are there, and these vehicles or these objects can move from in a straight path. Okay, so that you have to make here. Then group the motion of these objects, and also you have to make a group of these motion of these objects, okay, as slow and fast. Then next it is question is asked here that how did you decide which object is moving slow and which one is moving fast. So can you do you know that how we can decide that any object is moving slow or is moving fast? Do you know? Yes, correct. So by their movement, or whatever time they require to move from one place to another, by this we can get an idea that which vehicle is moving faster and which vehicle is not going to move faster, okay, or which is going slowly. So if vehicles are moving on a road in the same direction, we can easily tell which one of them is moving faster than the other. So what it is given? So if vehicles are moving on a road in the same direction, so we can easily tell which one of them is moving faster than the other. So it means whenever these vehicles are going by road or on a road, that time only we can say that some vehicles are going forward and some are remaining behind them. Okay, so which vehicles are faster, some vehicles are remain behind them, so that is why these are slower, we can say. So activity 13.1 is given here to understand that how we can identify that which vehicle is going or which object is moving faster and which object is not moving faster or it is moving slower. So we will read this activity 13.1. So look at figure 13.1. It shows the position of some vehicles moving on a road in the same direction at some instant of the time. So now look at figure 13.2. It shows the position of same vehicles after some time. So see what it is given. In 13.1, the vehicles moving on a road, okay, so in 13.1 it is also shown that position of some vehicles which are moving on a road and which are moving in a same direction at the some instant time. So they require particular time. Then in 13.2, what it is given? So it shows the position of same vehicles after some time. So in 13.2, what it is given? That whatever vehicles are there in 13.1, after some time or by changing their position, you can see same vehicles after some particular time. So from your observation of the two figures, answer the following questions. So what questions are here? First question, which vehicle is moving the fastest of all? So what you have to tell first? So which vehicle is moving the fastest of all? Then which one of them is moving the slowest? So the distance moved by objects in a given interval of time can help us to decide which one is faster or which one is slower. So for example, imagine that you have gone to see of your friend at the bus stand. Then suppose you start pedaling your bicycle at the same time as the bus begins to move. So the distance covered by you, after 5 minutes would be much smaller than that covered by the bus. So would you say that the bus is moving faster than the bicycle? Okay. So whatever example is given here, so first we will see these pictures, then we will try to get answers of these two questions. So first picture you can see here, 13.1, vehicles moving in the same direction on a road. So here some vehicles are there on a road, and you can see that all these vehicles are moving in the same direction. Okay. And in this second picture, 13.2, you can see the position of vehicles shown in position of vehicles after some time. So see which vehicle is moving faster. So here you can see this one is moving faster, and this white one, which is at last, you can see this is moving slower. But one more example is given here. In this picture you can identify easily because all these vehicles are moving in the same direction on the same road, and also they are given a particular time, or the same timing they are given here. That is why we can identify that which vehicle is moving faster and which vehicle moving slower. So this is very easy. This example is very easy to identify which one is moving faster and which one is moving slower. Now another example is given here. So let us read this one more time. See what it is given. So imagine that you have gone to see off your friend. So you went to see off your friend, okay, at bus stand. Then suppose you start pedaling your bicycle at the same time as the bus begins. So how you went to bus stand with your friend? So you went with bicycle. On bicycle you went there to bus stand, okay, with your friend. And when your friend will go inside that bus, and that bus will start. So what you have to do, whenever that bus is going to move from its place, or it will start, so what you have to do, so you have to start pedaling your bicycle also. Okay, whenever that bus will start, then you also have to start pedaling your bicycle. Okay, at the same time you have to do this with bus, you have to move. Then distance covered by you after 5 minutes. So suppose you exactly started your bicycle when your friend's bus will start, and after 5 minutes what you have to do, after 5 minutes you have to see that what exactly distance you covered after 5 minutes be much smaller than that covered by the bus. So when that bus also start, and when you will also start with bus your bicycle, then after 5 minutes you have to answer that what will happen here. So bus will faster, or you will be the faster one? So would you say that the bus is moving faster than the bicycle? Yes, correct. So bus will move faster than the bicycle. So you cannot move faster as your friend's bus will go, or it will move fast. Okay, so that is the difference in between bicycle and also bus and bicycle. So whenever there is a distance covered by two objects, so how we can get we come to know that which one is faster and which one is slower. So by the distance which is covered by these objects, we can get that which one is faster and which one is slower, but time should be similar there. Now let us move to our next one. Next paragraph, it is, we often say that the faster vehicle has a higher speed. In a 100 meter race, it is easy to decide whose speed is highest. One who takes shortest time to cover the distance of 100 meters has the highest speed. So what is here? So like these vehicles 13.1 and 13.2, if suppose there is a 100 meter race in your school, so how we can identify or how we can decide that our sport teacher or sports sir, what they are doing here? So whenever there is a 100 meter race of your class or in between 3 students, 5 students, 10 students, so on ground you make some marks, but these marks are always in a straight line, okay? And when you are running in a straight line, it is easy to decide that which student is going faster and which student is going slower. So one who takes shortest time to cover the distance of 100 meters has the highest speed. Or we can say, whenever the student which that student take a shortest time, or that student will reach wherever there is a 100 meters mark in minimum time, or first who will reach there at the 100 meters point, that student will be the winner. And we can say that student is having highest speed for running or in running, okay, we can say, or that sport teacher also will tell you like this only, okay? So like this we can decide that that student which is having highest speed and which is having a lowest speed, and by this we can decide who is the winner and who is not. So this is the example given here. So that is given here in this first point, which is 13.1, it means slow or fast. So in 13.1 it is given that there are so many objects which are moving from their places, and they are moving from their places with a particular speed. But how this speed it is decided? So by distance and time. So that is why we should have to learn what is exactly mean 13.2, which is a speed. So let us know that second point of this lesson, 13.2, speed. So see, you are probably familiar with the word speed, okay? So you know, you learned about this word speed. In the examples given above, a higher speed seems to indicate that a given distance has been covered in a shorter time, or a larger distance covered in a given time. So whatever examples we decided in a first point, 13.1, all these examples are helping us to understand, or they are given for that a higher speed seems to indicate that a given distance has been covered in a shorter time, or a larger distance covered in a given time. Okay, so like this we can decide their speed. It means which is the highest and which is the lowest. So one more time I am going to read this. Read with me also. See, in above example, a higher speed seems to indicate that a given distance has been covered in a shorter time, or a larger distance covered in a given time. So this is like this we can decide speed of any object, of any vehicle. So when we will read this point, after this I will make you to understand how exactly it is given okay. So let us first read this point, and then when then after that I will explain you. So see, the most convenient way to find out which of the two or more objects is moving faster is to compare the distances moved by them in a unit time. So thus we know the distance covered by two buses in a 1 hour. We can tell which one is slower, and we call the distance covered by an object in a unit. So time as the speed of the object. So see, read this one more time. So the most convenient way to find out which of the two or more objects is moving faster is compared to the distances. Then distances moved by them in a unit time. So thus, if we know the distance covered by two buses in a 1 hour, we can tell which one is slower, and we call the distance covered by an object in a unit time as the speed of the object. So when we say that a car is moving with a speed of 50 kilometers per hour, it implies that it will cover a distance of 50 kilometers in a 1 hour. If suppose by this, whatever now we read now, so by this, if suppose we are going to say that a car can move with the speed of 50 kilometers per hour, it means that car can be go 50 kilometers in a 1 hour, okay. So however, a car seldom moves with a constant speed for 1 hour. In fact, it starts moving slowly and then picks up speed. So when we say that a car has a speed of 50 kilometers per hour, we usually consider only the total distance covered by it in 1 hour. So whenever we are saying that a car speed is having 50 kilometers for 1 hour, it doesn't mean that car is going to move constantly at a particular speed for 1 hour, okay. So whenever that seldom, it means that driver of that car is going to run that car, so it can be, or it may be faster, or after some time it will be slower, and it means not constant speed is there. That speed can be slower or faster. That car is moving slowly sometimes, or that car moving faster sometimes. So it is not constant for whole the 50 kilometers, or not for the continuous 1 hour. So we usually consider only the total distance covered by it in 1 hour. So we do not bother whether the car has been moving with a constant speed or not during that hour, okay. So that we are not going to bother here. See, a constant speed or not during that hour. So the speed calculated here is actually the average speed of the car. So in this book, we shall use the term speed for average speed. So for us, the speed is the total distance covered divided by the total time taken. This speed is equal to, this is the formula of speed by which we can get. So whatever speed of that object is there, or whatever speed of that vehicle is there. So speed is equal to total distance covered, whatever distance is there, and it is divided by total time which is taken to reach at some point. Okay. So like this we can get speed, whatever speed of any object. So in 13.1, first picture and second picture, only by seeing or by observing you decided that how these cars are faster or slower. But in this, now by this speed formula, we can decide that exactly which object is faster and which object is slower. Okay, so we can decide in a scientific manner speed of these vehicles or objects. So now I am going to explain you whatever we learned in a 13.2. So motion and time. So children, in this 13.2, whatever it is given, so when we saw that a car is there, some cars are there on a road, so these cars are moving in a straight line. So this is a road, okay, and these are cars, we can say, or these are vehicles, okay. So suppose, so in 13.1 they are moving in a same direction, okay. So when they will reach here, so when that car, suppose this is the distance is given, so this is a distance, so to reach from this A point to the B point, so these vehicles need some time here. Okay, so whenever you saw or you observed 13.1 picture and 13.2 picture, that time by observing only you can see that this car is highest, and whenever this car is remaining here, so this is the slowest one and this is the highest one. Okay, so by observation only we can say that that first car who reach here at the B point first, that is the faster one, or this is having highest speed. And whenever there is a at the particular time or at the given time, suppose they are given 5 minutes or they are given 10 minutes, okay, so after 10 minutes or 5 minutes they reach, this car reached here at B point, but this one, it is not reaching near to these cars, okay. So this is a at the last number, okay. So that is why this car is having a slowest speed, or this is a slower. So but whenever there is a scientific measurement of their distances, we can't by observation only we can't decide their distance or which car is highest or which car is lowest. This we cannot decide, okay. So how we can decide this? So that only we discussed here in 13.2. So we discussed in 13.2 that how we can decide that which car is highest and having highest speed, or which is the highest or faster, or which is the slower. So that we discussed in 13.2, but now I can't explain you because we are not having time, that much time. So in our next session we will discuss that how exactly we can decide and how exactly that formula of speed can be used in a science to decide that vehicle or that object is faster or slower, okay. So we will stop here. In our next session we will discuss our next point. Thank you.